On this page, we're going to continue looking at acids, which if you recall have hydrogens or a hydrogen in the COOH group here. And we will also look at bases, which have the hydroxides or a nitrogen in them. And so here we're going to look at how these different substances react with water and add a few more vocabulary terms to what we're doing. So for HCl, I could write this reaction with water over the arrow, and I could say that it splits into H plus and Cl minus. We're not generally going to do that. We're going to do reactions that look more like this, where my H, so this is an acid, and it's a proton donor. So that proton is going to get donated to the other substance here, and as a result, so that's an H plus that's moving over. I have not H2O, but H3O, and now it has a positive charge on it because that H plus moved over. If I think about what's left over here, that would be Cl minus. And so I can see that this is producing protons, just drawn in a couple of different ways. This is what we would call a strong acid, and for strong acids, you need to memorize that hydrochloric acid is a strong acid. There are six other strong acids, but you just are responsible for knowing HCl is a strong acid. We'll also see some strong bases over here in a minute. Now, this is vinegar, and this is obviously not as dangerous as hydrochloric acid, so this is what we call a weak acid. And you will notice that this contains some carbons in it, so I would say that this is an organic acid, and we can see over here on the base side there's some carbons too, so our weak acids and weak bases often are organic or contain carbons in their structure. So let's take a look here. We've identified that this is an acid. It's got that H, and this whole group is called a carboxylic acid, which we'll see more of in chapter 13, but this proton is going to get donated to the other compound here. And so that leaves me with an H3O plus again. So I send that H plus over. And then I just want to copy carefully the rest of this. CH3, COO with a negative. It's lost that positive charge, so now it has a negative. And again, anytime an acid reacts, I should get a proton as a product. I will leave this one for you to try, okay? So taking a look over here at the bases, I have sodium hydroxide. And that is a strong base. The way you can tell your strong bases is that they always have a metal and a hydroxide in them. So strong bases all have a metal and a hydroxide. These just break apart into ions when you put them into water. So that would be an example there. I'll leave another one for you to try. Down here is a weak base that would have a nitrogen in it, and if you can think back to Lewis structures, there's a lone pair of electrons on that nitrogen, and that's going to be the location that's able to accept a proton right on that nitrogen. So my H plus is going to get donated over here. This is a base from that nitrogen there, and so I would say that this is a proton acceptor. So if I rewrite this, CH3 stays unchanged, but that nitrogen has picked up another hydrogen. So now it's NH3 with a positive charge because the positive moved there. What's left of the water is a hydroxide, and you can start to spot a pattern here that whether you're a strong base or a weak base with that organic carbons in it, you're always going to produce hydroxides. Another couple of patterns that we can see here, if you notice all the products here and all the products here, all of the products of these reactions contain ions, which we wouldn't have expected. If you remember back over on the first page, we said most molecular compounds, which don't have ions in them usually, but all of these produce ions, and so that tells me that these are all electrolytes. A term for electrolytes, I could say these are strong electrolytes. So strong acids are strong electrolytes, and strong bases are strong electrolytes. They ionize completely to form all ions, And you can see that with these arrows going forward, that we're making only products, lots of ions. Now, a little detail here with the weak acid and the weak base. Notice I have the equilibrium arrows. So in reality, only about roughly 10% of this breaks up and forms ions, and the other 90% stays together as molecules. So up here, I would call these strong electrolytes, and I would call these weak electrolytes, because they don't form quite as many ions. They actually tend to stay together as molecules, but then maybe one out of every 10 goes through this ionization to form ions here. So